Welcome to Holy Spirit Catholic Community. This third Sunday in Ordinary Time inspires us to understand that Jesus has saved us, and we are called to spread that good news to others. For those who are visiting here today, we are glad you've joined us, and we wish you a warm welcome. Your presider today is Father Emil, assisted by Deacon Scott. Save the date, Saturday, February 11th from 9 a.m. to 1 p.m. for a Saturday of pastoral care, preparing for Lent and receiving the anointing of the sick. The Holy Spirit Catholic School will be holding its annual dinner auction on Saturday, February 11th at 6 p.m. at the Grand Idaho Inn and Suites. Please see the bulletin for more information. Please join us for coffee hour following Mass. And today we pray for the repose of the souls of the Ralph Doellman family.
Please stand and join us in our gathering song, 10,000 Reasons, number 562.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The Lord be with you. Good morning, dear brothers and sisters. Good to have you here after, to see you here after 2 weeks, because two last weeks I was not here at 11 a.m. It was good for me, for you, but bad for me. So I'm very happy having you. Also this week, and in fact yesterday, we had a rite of acceptance and welcome. So with us during the Mass, we have candidates to sacraments of Eucharist and confirmations and catechumens. So from this weekend, we also start to do dismissal after the homily. So only candidates and catechumens are dismissed and free to go, not all of you, because after that there is collection, so we have to stay. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries.
Lord Jesus, you are our light and our salvation. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you are the promised one. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are our health and our peace. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, direct our actions according to your good pleasure, that in the name of your beloved Son we may abound in good works. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. First, the Lord degraded the land of Zebulun and the land of Naphtali. But in the end, he has glorified the seaward road, the land west of the Jordan, the district of the Gentiles. Anguish has taken wing, dispelled is darkness, for there is no gloom where but now there was distress. People who have walked in darkness have seen a great light. Upon those who dwelt in the land of gloom, a light has shone. You have brought them abundant joy and great rejoicing, as they rejoice before you as at the harvest, as people make merry when dividing spoils. For the yoke that burdened them, the pole on their shoulder, and the rod of their taskmaster, you have smashed as on the day of Midian. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. I urge you, brothers and sisters, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, that all of you agree in what you say, that there be no divisions among you, but that you be united in the same mind and in the same purpose. For it has been reported to me about you, my brothers and sisters, by Chloe's people, that there are rivalries among you. I mean that each of you is saying, I belong to Paul, or I belong to Apollos, or I belong to Cephas, or I belong to Christ. Is Christ divided? Was Paul crucified for you? Or were you baptized in the name of Paul? For Christ did not send me to baptize, but to preach the gospel, and not with the wisdom of human eloquence, so that the cross of Christ might not be emptied of its meaning. The word of the Lord.
You. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. When Jesus heard that John had been arrested, he withdrew to Galilee. He left Nazareth and went to live in Capernaum by the sea, in the region of Zebulun and Naphtali, that what had been said through Isaiah the prophet might be fulfilled. Land of Zebulun and land of Naphtali, the way to the sea beyond the Jordan, Galilee of the Gentiles, the people who sit in darkness have seen a great light. On those dwelling in a land overshadowed by death, light has arisen. From that time on, Jesus began to preach and say, "Repent, for the kingdom of God is at hand." As he was walking by the Sea of Galilee, he saw two brothers, Simon, who is called Peter, and his brother Andrew, casting a net into the sea. They were fishermen. He said to them, "Come after me, and I will make you fishers of men." At once they left their nets and followed him. He walked along from there and saw two other brothers, James, the son of Zebedee, and his brother John. They were in a boat with their father Zebedee, mending their nets. He called them, and immediately they left their boat and their father and followed him. He went around all of Galilee, teaching in their synagogues, proclaiming the gospel of the kingdom, and curing every disease and illness among the people. The gospel of the Lord.
Thank you.
First, I had to prepare my book for dismissal, because if I have it in front of me, probably I will not forget to dismiss our catechumens and candidates. It's easy to forget about it. Dear brothers and sisters, today's gospel is very, very beautiful and provides us a lot of great reminders, because we know, we've heard about this gospel many times, but we have to always remind ourselves how important it is to follow the light, to follow our Lord Jesus Christ. Because we know that in the Bible, darkness is always used when the Bible is talking about sin. And of course, we don't like to hear that we are sinners. All of us, we like to hear good things about us. You know, if you meet someone, you always say, "Oh, you look so beautiful," even if not. "Oh, you are so nice," even if not. You know, if someone invites you for a dinner, you have to always say, "Oh, it's delicious," even if it's not. But that's what we like. We like to hear nice things about us, about ourselves. So, you know, the same as me, you know, after homily, I like to hear, "Oh, Father, your homily was so great." No, it wasn't, but I like to hear about it. Oh, Deacon Scott probably has the same problem, yes? We all like to hear good things about us. And to hear, "Oh, you are a sinner," I don't like it. "You have to change your life, you have to repent," I don't like it. But also, if I have to go to the doctor and doctor says, "You are sick," I don't like to hear it. I don't like to hear that something is wrong with me. But we know that if I go to the physician and I'm sick, and he tells me about it, he's telling me about it, it's not to humiliate me, it's to help me. I have to understand that I'm sick to receive a proper procedures, yes? That's what I have to do. And the same is in the gospel. Always when gospel says, "You are a sinner, repent," it's not to humiliate me, to say you are a bad person. No, it's not about it. It's just to help me to understand I need to change something. And in our Christian Catholic point of view is, I can't stay in darkness because of the fact that Christ is my light. So why I want to stay in darkness? And we know that we don't like darkness. Yesterday evening I said that I have to prepare for homilies for today, and this is for this weekend, so this is the third one. And always I'm discovering different points of views and different ideas for this homily. And yes, that's true that we don't like darkness. You know, if we turn off now all the lights in the church and cover all windows, and it will become dark in the church, we don't like it. Because when it is dark, you can't read your breaking bread, you can't sing, musicians can't play, but musicians, they have their own lamp, so it's easier. But they can't sing, in fact. They can sing maybe, yes, but not play. And if it's dark, we don't feel safe. We have some kids in the church, and you know, we know that in dark room, kids feel not very well. Sometimes parents, they have to just leave a small lamp somewhere in the corner, because darkness is not our natural environment. That's why for people so great invention was to find fire. That's why for us electricity is so important. That's why we need light. That's why also light helps us to wake up. You know, maybe it's nothing to be proud, but I'm a big fan of Alexa. Because my Alexa in the morning, I bought a set of four plugins. And now my Alexa, when my timer is on at 5 a.m., also my light is turned on. And this light just hits in my eyes. And I have to wake up. And I don't like it. But we know that if we stay whole day in darkness in our bed, we will probably just waste our time. We won't do anything what is useful and fruitful for us and for our families, for our community. We need light. Even sometimes this light is too strong for us. And I'm looking for, my shoes, just to throw it into my lamp. Even I say, Alexa, turn off the light. After a few minutes, next timer and next light. So this light is working and it's just lighting on me. And in fact, we love light. And you know, even during the winter in Idaho, it's pretty dark in the morning and in the evening also, it's very early, it's dark. And some people, they just try to escape for a few weeks or even days to Florida or to other warmer states because we love sun, we love light. And the same is in our spiritual life. Christ is our light. He provides us everything what we need. We know that without light, it's impossible for plants to grow. If we have no light, we have no potatoes. In Idaho, we understand it very well. Without light, there is no life. So Christ is our light. And he brings us his light and life to our lives. So today's gospel and the calling of the apostles, we very often this calling, we use this passage from the gospel talking about priestly vocation. Okay, it's about that. But also all of us are called by Christ to follow him. Not only priests, not only bishops, not only deacons, all of us. We are all invited by Christ to follow him. And dear brothers and sisters, it's very important to remember that our faith is a grace, is a gift from God. It means God invites us to follow him. It's his invitation. It means all of us who are here at some point, we've heard his voice, follow me. That's why we are here. We've heard his voice, follow me. That's why we spend this Sunday here, Sunday morning here in the church. And and our candidates and catechumens are here because they've heard at some point, follow me. And they are here. And dear brothers and sisters, this decision to follow Christ is not just one-time decision. It means 15 years ago, I decided to be a priest, so now a decision is done. No, every day I have to decide to follow Christ. Every day we have to decide to follow Christ. Every morning I have to say, I want to follow Christ. Because I know how important he is for my life, and I know that he is only one source of real, never-ending light. And we don't want to stay in darkness. We want to stay in light, because we need light to be happy. There is also a medical term, I don't know if it's correctly translated by me into English, but it's called winter depression. It means because of the lack of light, our mood during the winter season is much worse than during the summer. Our spiritual life should be always in a good mood because always we have light of Christ. And dear brothers and sisters, it's also necessary today to remind us first reading and to say a few words about first reading. We are actually in the church. This week is called a week of prayers for Christian unity. We pray to God that one day all Christians will be together. There will not be any divisions among us because we know that division among Christians is a shame. And it's anti-testimony to other people who are not Christians. So that's why we pray that one day we'll stay together around one altar, united in Eucharist, and we'll be one church all over the world. We don't know when, but we believe that maybe one day it will be possible. But also, it's a great reminder for all of us about unity in our community. We need to be united in our community. I urge you, brothers and sisters, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, that all of you agree in what you say and that there be no divisions among you, but that you be united in the same mind and in the same purpose. And this letter is written just for us here in Pocatello, Idaho, 83201. It's for us. And it's a great task for us. Because, you know, to be very honest, it's not easy, not difficult sometimes to find divisions among us. Because St. Paul says, by the way, St. Paul had his own secret service, Jewish people, and they told him what's going on in the community. And the thing is that it's so easy to be, you know, to be united at some point, but also it's so easy for us to keep divisions among us. He uses this example: I belong to Paul, or I belong to Apollos, or I belong to Cephas. But we can tell, you know, remember a few weeks ago I changed some words, one word in the gospel, putting Pocatello there. I can change this passage from the letter of St. Paul, also putting different names. I mean that each of you is saying, I belong to St. John's, or I belong to St. Anthony's, or I belong to St. Joseph's. And sometimes it's a problem that we are very connected to our place, our chapel we have, but we have to remember that we are one parish community. And about that is today's reading. I know that for some people it's hard to listen to that, but that's the reality of the Bible. We have to be united. We can have our own preferences. That's not prohibited to have our own preferences. You may like this priest better than other priests, natural thing. I can't have any preferences because my vocation is to like all of you. With deacon is pretty simple in our parish because we have one, so we have no choice to like a deacon. But about chapel, okay, we can love this one better, this one maybe less, but we are still united in Christ. We are still one parish. And we have to fight for this unity in prayer, in love. We have to be focused on our main and most important task. And what is our most important task in our parish community? What is our goal? Holiness, yes, perfect. Holiness is our main task. So that's why we want to be united, and that's why we want to be together. That's why we want to pray together. That's why we want to love one another. That's why we want to participate in Eucharist together, giving a testimony of unity around us. Because people looking at us, the first thing is they are looking at our love among us and unity. And unity is a fruit of love. If there is a love among us, if there is prayer among us, if there are real relations and friendships among us, if you are united around Christ, people will be amazed by that. And we will bring much more people to the church, to our parish, because they will be amazed because of our unity. And unity was a thing Christ was praying during Last Supper. This long, very beautiful prayer. Christ was praying for unity of his disciples. And dear brothers and sisters, we have to do everything to be united with Christ. Because Christ wants that. And it doesn't mean that any differences among us are not allowed. There are allowed. Yesterday evening I said, of course, it will be perfect for me that all of you are like me. It will be very nice. Boring, but very nice for me. But the thing is that if we are different, and our community have different people with different personalities, with different skills, with different characters, with different backgrounds, it makes our community very rich, because these differences, they shouldn't lead us to divisions. They should lead us to discover how rich, because of us and these differences, our community is. Because Christianity is not about being the same. Christianity is about being united with Christ. And learn how can I accept differences among us. Because we can't change other people. One person will sing loudly, another one will not sing, one person will pray in this way, another person in this way. There's nothing wrong. What I can do, remember that Christ unites us around him, and I can also accept differences we have. Because as I said, all of us are different, but we are all children of God, united in the church, in Roman Catholic, Holy Roman Catholic Church, in a beautiful and what I feel very united parish in Pocatello. Amen.
Amen.
So now is the time for dismissal. So I would like to ask our candidates and catechumens to stand. Almighty God, source of all creation, you have made us in your image. Receive with love those who come before you. Lead our catechumens to the baptism of new birth and our candidates to a deeper share in the Paschal mystery, so that, living a fruitful life in the company of your faithful, they may receive the eternal reward that you promise. We ask this in the name of Jesus the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Catechumens, go in peace, and may the Lord remain with you always. Please stand. I believe in one God. To lighten our load and free us from oppression. Let us lift up prayer, confident that God's reign is near.
For the Church, that all Christ's faithful people will commit themselves to bring his light to the whole world, let us pray to the Lord.
The Lord, hear our prayer.
For world peace, that all people, cultures, faiths may strive to end discrimination and seek equal justice and liberty for all, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That in due time, our catechumens may be able to receive the baptism of new birth and renewal in the Holy Spirit, and our candidates be found worthy to complete their initiation through the sacraments of confirmation and Eucharist, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
for all who are sick or homebound, and for our elderly, that they will experience the healing touch of Jesus in their lives. Let us pray to the Lord. And for our own parish, that as disciples united in communion with Christ, we may also be one in our witness and service and mission. Let us pray to the Lord.
Faithful God, you gather all people together by the power of your Holy Spirit. Grant what we dare to ask in faith through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated for the children's offering.
Thank you.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. With humble spirit and contrite heart may be accepted by you, O Lord, and may our sacrifice in your sight this day be pleasing to you, Lord God. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Accept our offerings, O Lord, we pray, and in sanctifying them, grant that they may profit us for salvation. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your Word, through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin.
For you and holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so, with the angels and all the saints, we declare your glory, as with one voice we acclaim.
The fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Peter, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, you may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory of yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles,
Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Let us offer each other a sign of peace. Peace be with you.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. We need one more Eucharistic minister. Thank you.
Thank you.
for all who are participating in this Mass at home. Let us now pray the spiritual act of communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and I unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that receiving the grace by which you bring us to new life, we may always glory in your gift. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
One short reminder from me, I don't know what about Deacon Scott, but this week we still keep one priest schedule, despite of the fact that Father Henry is back. So I just want to say that Father Henry is safely back in Pocatello. But this week we still have just one mass, one daily mass, 8 a.m. Monday at St. John's Student Center, 7 a.m. Tuesday at St. Joseph, 8:15 at St. Anthony on Wednesday, Thursday, 7 a.m. at St. Joseph, and Friday at noon here in the main church, and at 9 a.m. on Saturday at St. John's Student Center. But please check the bulletin, because you know I could messed up something.
Just please keep our candidates and catechumens in your prayers. Today we had one with us in front and two in back that didn't come forward. We'll get them to come forward next time. But we have a total of six, I believe. So please just, you are the primary catechizing body for these candidates and catechumens. They learn their faith from your love and communion, from your commitment, and from your wisdom. So please keep them in your prayers, introduce yourselves to them when you see them, and support them.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace. Thanks be to God.
Our sending forth song is Sing to the Mountains, number 584. Sing to the Mountains.